Hey everyone, let's make slippers all in one piece. All you do is have to sew up the sides and the back by the ankle. I'm using the Fleexe Loom Chunky 14 links. I have my peg, my loom already marked out from the first peg to the last peg. And when we're going to be binding off the one side and binding off the other side. This pattern is based off the knitting needles all-in-one piece slipper. There's multiples out there. Here we go. Let's start. Start by making your slip knot. And we're going to e-wrap clockwise, and we're going to knit counterclockwise. And coming to the last peg, we're going to e-wrap it again. Now we're going to go counterclockwise and we're going to knit, wrap the last peg again. It's loose, it's okay, just rock it and it tightens nicely. Same thing with the corners. If you set up your Fleexe Loom this way, it can get a little loose. Just gently rug it and it tightens right back up. And this is the U knit, not the true knit. Came undone. No problem. You just go back and put that back on your hook, on your peg, and go back. on the last peg, we're going to knit it. It might be a little hard because it's your first peg. There you go. Alright, that is our cast on. Again, we e-wrapped clockwise and we knit it counterclockwise. Alright, making sure you do not join your first and your last peg. Now for the pattern, you are always knitting the first peg and your last peg. You're going to knit and then purl all your other pegs until you get to the last peg, and then you're going to knit. This way it gives your edges a nice and clean look. To purl, you're going to go from the top down, and you're going to put your working yarn underneath and scoop it up, and you're going to pick it up off the loom and put your new loop right back on. You don't want it too tight, so when you come back around, it's not so hard to get off the loom. Again, from the bottom up, and gently pull. And this is the pattern for the whole sock. Purling one way and knitting back the other. The part that we're making right now is the ankle. So this is also customizable. You don't need to do it so long or so short, however much you want your ankle to be covered. For this pattern, we're going to do 27 rows. This gives you a long ankle cuff that is also able to be folded down. All right, so now we're on the last peg. We're going to knit this one. And there we go, we're done with row one. Now we're gonna come back on row two. We're going to knit again the last peg. And we're going to knit all the other pegs again. Back at your first peg, I'm going to knit it off. That is the end of row two. Starting row three, again, you're going to knit that first peg. And we're going to go purling. All right, now we're on the last peg and we're going to knit this one. Don't panic if it comes off the loop. Just put it right back on. Just like that. That was the end of row 3. Now to row 4. I'm going to knit this one again. And knit the rest of the pegs. Back to your first peg, and we're going to knit it. That is the end of row 4. Now, if you can see, it starts giving you that 3D effect. And it's nice and clean edges. And on your ends, you can see there's little bumps, and that's going to help us when we have to sew this. All right, so let's pause and do your 27 rows, and we'll be on to the next step. Stay tuned. Alrighty, so now you should have your 27 rows, and this is what it looks like. See a nice clean edge. It's going to be much easier for us to sew it when we're done. And this is what the top of the ankle looks like. As you can see, there's no curling. And this pattern does have a stretch to it. Okay, now we're going to bind off. We're going to bind off from your end peg to your marker peg. Now this part will vary depending on the width of your foot, so just make sure you measure your foot when you mark your pegs. We're going to do a simple bind off. And we're gonna still knit that last peg. Then we're gonna knit the next peg. All right, now we're gonna take this peg and this loop and put it on this peg here. And knit it again. Then you take this loop and put it over here. And you're going to knit the next peg. Take the loop and go backwards. Then we're going to go over here and we're going to continue the process. Don't forget to tighten up as you go. Alrighty, now for me, I'm on my last two. Alrighty, now if you notice, only that first peg we knit it off again. It's kind of to make it more like a boxy instead of that perfect round you normally get. And then it's nice and tight. Alright, since I've already knitted this one, I'm going to automatically go to the next peg. Continuing the pattern. All right, back to your starter peg. Knit it again. Knit the one next to it. Put your second loop back on your first loop. Little tug. Remember to knit it again. All right. Now I'm going to take this one and put it back over here. And we're going to go next and knit off. Okay, now I'm on my last two of them. Alrighty, so now this is my new starter peg. So now this one I'm going to be purling all the way to the end, then knitting that last peg and returning all knits. We're on the last peg now, and we're going to knit that off. This is our new row one. Returning on a knit. Again, don't freak out when your loops come off. Take your time and replace them. Back to my new starter peg. That is row two. Re-knit. And now we're going to go back to purling until we get to our last peg and knit that one. All right, now I'm at the end peg. We're going to knit that one off. All right, now if you see, Nice little corner. And a nice little corner. You're going to end up forming like a T shape. This is our ankle. Now we're designing the foot and the top of the foot. It's just measuring your foot from the end of your heel where it curves and then go all the way to the bottom around your toes, right up again to your ankle. For me, that's 18 inches. So I will see you back as soon as we're done. Stay tuned. Hey everybody, we're back. After you did the length of your foot, mine is 18 inches for mine. It's going to be a big T is what you're looking for. Now we're going to do the bind off and sew up the sides. Just like the bind off we did previously did, we're going to come back around and knit and then knit the next one. Then you take from the second and put it back on the first. Give it a little snug tight. You're going to knit over. Oh. There. Knit over. Then you're going to knit again. Okay. Then you're going to bring it over. Knit the next one. Bring it back. And knit off. Well, now we're down to the last two pegs. And one last time. Alrighty, so now you should have a nice edging. Whether you have a little corner here, and then you'll have your corner over here. Now it's your choice to either knot it right there or continue using the two strands or one strand of yarn that you're working with. Oh, tie it nice and tight. Then you're going to line it up with the beginning T. Thread your needle. You're going to use the edges for your sewing guide. So you're already on this side, you want to join it. You're going to take it from the lump or bump and you're going to thread it through. And you're going to go back and forth like a zigzag all the way into the end. Giving it a nice little tug because you want them close together as you're going along. So you can see you've got one here, and it staggers. All right, keep going and I'll meet you down at the toe end. All right, you should be at the toe right now. Now it's decision making time. You have two options. You can either sew the toe, finish it off in the inside, keeping it a seamless edge, or you can turn it inside out and have a border on the edge of your slipper. I personally like this side, so I'm going to finish it off on the outside. Again, you can stitch it up however you like. As long as it is secured, you'll be just fine. Just like closing a hat, how you go over your stitches just a couple times and then knot it off. See? Nicely done. Then when you're done, you just take your scissors, snip it off, knot it however you like, snip off the excess. Again, there's no right or wrong reason on how you finish your project. Okay, and then there's one side done. And looking it open, if you just decide to do the seamless side, that's what it would look like. Again, I like the ridges, so the side of my slipper is going to look like that. Okay, so after you're done with the one side, then you're going to line it up just like you did the one side. Now you're going to do the opposite side. Starting from the top, working your way down, finishing the toe. Then you're going to do your ankle. Now, just like you did the sides, you're going to do, I start from the top and work my way down. You can do vice versa. Just making sure that the zigzags line up. So when you're going back and forth, it's like the zipper effect. Then after you're done doing that, you're going to seam the sides. This might be a little difficult, but again, with our nice clean edges, it's a breeze. Which end you decide to choose on, you're going to start it up and you're going to go back and forth all the way through, catching the outer circle loops, taking the outer loops, all the way down to the other end. Then when you're done, you're going to either leave it like this or flip it inside out. All right, I will catch up with you at the end of the project. All right, everybody, we're back for the final stage. You should have already knitted both your sides of your sock, and you should have knitted the ankle part together and the back of your heel area. So it should look kinda like this. Again, don't stress about that backing right here. It's going to be a little snug around your ankle. That just helps with the comfort and your sock not slipping off your foot. I'm going to go ahead and bring it inside out. All right. So now this is what mine looks like because I chose to have the pattern on one side, and there it looks on the other side. And this is what the back looks like. As you can see, it has that little ridging here. And of course, that pattern that I have on the sides of my sock is right here. So this way you know which is the front and which is the back because you have sealed it. Then if you want, you can always pull it down to make it just an ankle sock. Like that. Well, I hope you like this tutorial. If you do, let me know. If you have a different way of stitching something or you have a favorite way of making a sock, share your ideas with the rest of us. As always, happy looming.